No, you're fine, you're fine. I'll move it. Thank you. Okay. All right.
So, you know, there was a new moon on Thursday, which was also in Libra. So, based on coffee, yeah, I'm right there. So, based on, you know, what is happening in your chart, if you have a strong Libra placement, the Libra season could be, I don't even have a word for it, honestly. Challenging is not really the word. It's just like, it's just so all over the place. Anybody feeling all over the place? A little bit all over the place. Okay. So, you know, that's kind of right par for the course. So I would like, what I really, the intention that Bobby and I and Erica went to Xavier Rudd's concert, which is like eons ago. That's pre-COVID. And it was so good in Xavier, right? It was so good. Anyway, so my intention for your practice to find a place in the middle of the store, right? In the center of the hurricane, if you will, in the eye of the storm, and ultimately that is the higher octave objective for a Libra season, is to stand grounded in the middle of a windstorm. You know, anytime we are in an air season, it's very windy, if you will. You could totally put it that way. The air signs, obviously air, you know, kind of comes with the wind territory. And there's so much motion that maybe may seem invisible, or it may seem, you know, potentially, invisible is a good word. You can't quite see it, but you can feel it moving at all times. So finding the groundiness in the center of the storm is ultimately the objective, right? Being able to just stand still in a way, and then watch outward with a certain level of discernment, or as much discernment as possible, seemingly being unaffected by, you know, the craziness of the outside. Not an easy task by any means. Not an easy task, but that's kind of what it's been feeling like. So the full moon, I mean new moon rather, has been also in Libra, just adding a little more of that energy into the mix. It has now moved into Scorpio, so it will actually bring a little more depth into it, which will, I think, already feels nice today. As we move on to Scorpio season next week, that will be a whole another change, and I'm going to talk about that next week. It should be interesting. And then with Mars and Mercury still in retrograde, we still have Jupiter and Saturn also in retrograde. So there's just a lot of internal processing, whichever way you want to look at it. So standing in the center, whether you look at inward or outward, or in a way both directions, I think is kind of the invitation here. Standing in the middle, looking inward, and then as well as outward. So the playlist is great. It's called Full Circle. It's, here we go.
I was like, is it gonna work? Okay.
All right, once I start it, it should be fine. Okay, so the playlist is called 10-17-20 Full Circle. It is all for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Let's begin. 9:09. A little delay, but that's okay. Hopefully you can squeeze everything in there that I planned. So, no. Sit bone connected to the mat. Take a moment, find your center. Breath is the ultimate center of your center. If you would even picture yourself sitting or standing calmly in the middle of a wind whirl, rooting down through your sit bones, activating your breath, reminding you that stillness is really difficult to achieve. Breath in through your nose. Hold it at the top, sip it a little more. Open mouth, release. Again, breath in through your nose. Hold it. it at the top, sip it a little more. Open mouth, release. Seal your lips, find your ujjayi. Even inhale, even exhale. As you exhale, feel into the depth of your core muscles. Just a couple of those even breaths here, warming yourselves from inside. Start bringing your shoulders into the mix. Roll the shoulders up and back. Drop the head side to side, just the head, nothing else. Keep moving it and one more time back to the first side, back to the second side. Palms reach up over your head, interlace the palms. Lift the heart up, lift the palms up. So a little bit of a lower back. Stretch, low lumbar. Release the hands, put them behind you, fingertips facing away from your seat. Lean into your hands, shoulder blades in, lift up through your heart. Back into the center. Come actually forward, put your hands forward. And then same thing, but chin into the chest and round. Coming onto your hands and knees. Find your way to tabletop. Shift your hips all the way back into heels, child's pose. Suction cup your fingertips, arms go off the mat. Chin into the chest, come forward into tabletop, belly engaged, supporting your low back. Shift forward, stay on your knees, elbows in, chin and chest comes down. Inhale, heart comes through. It's a medium-ish cobra, full weight on in your hands, hips go back, child's pose. Again, lift the elbows. Suction cup the fingertips, activate the arms. Chin into the chest, back to tabletop. Bend the elbows, shift forward, find a little bit of a chaturanga on your knees. Inhale, heart comes through, bend through the elbows, brushing the ribcage. Back to child's one more time. Long through the arms, activate the fingers, activate the full arm. For length of the arm, back to tabletop. Last one, chin into forward, elbows in, halfway down, chin and chest. Inhale through your up dog, now roll over your feet, downward facing dog. Shift your hips way back. Step into your heels, lengthen through the arms. Any movement that you need to do, bend your knees here and there. Walk your feet all the way in front of your space. Halfway lift, lengthen, crown of the head reaches, chest lift. Legs active, exhale, fold. Two more, halfway up, lengthen, reach, feel the spine moving, notice the tension, tightness, exhale, fold. Last one, inhale, lengthen. Exhale, release. All the way up. Arms reach up, grab opposite elbows. Slightly bend in the knees. Inhale, lift. Exhale, off to your right. Reach, reach, reach. Back to center. Inhale, lift. Exhale, off to your left. Reach, reach, reach. Arms reach. Interlace your hands at the low back. Or grab a wrist or something. Inhale, lift. Maybe keeping the elbows bent. Notice how the shoulders feel here, how the shoulder blades are. Hinge at the waist, all the way down. Release the arms as you come into your fold. Halfway lift, fly back. Right leg lift, step it back, right knee ground. Arms rise, inhale, pick up the speed a little. Arms frame the foot. Step your left foot back, downward facing dog. Right leg lift, up and back. Step your right foot in, left knee finds the mat. Chest lift. Half split, bring it back. Back to front, into standing forward fold. Half
halfway lift, flat back, exhale, release. All the way up, arms reach, grab opposite elbows, inhale, lift, exhale to your right. Inhale, lift, exhale to your left, find engagement through the quads, arms reach. Interlace your hands at the low back, give it a space, inhale, reach with the heart. Exhale, fold, let the arms fall over your head, release them. Halfway lift, flat back, exhale, release, left leg lift, up and back. Step it back, left knee down, arms rise, inhale. Arms go down, frame the foot, downward facing dog, step your right foot back, left leg extends long, pull it. Step your left foot in, right knee down, chest lifts. Half split, bring it back. Standing forward fold is next, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, release. All the way up, arms reach, hands to heart, bring it in. Inhale up, exhale, fold. Right leg lift, slight vertical split, stepping back, right knee finds the mat. Arms rise, inhale. Arms go down, frame the foot, step it back, downward facing, right leg up, inhale, long. Step it in, left knee down, chest lifts, half splits, bring it back. Back to front, standing forward fold, halfway lift right there. Exhale, release. All the way up, arms reach, hands too hard, bring it in. Inhale up. Exhale, fold. Left leg lift, slight vertical split, stepping back, left knee finds the mat. Arms rise, lift. Arms go down, frame the foot, downward facing dog, step it back, left leg reaches right away. Step it all the way in, right knee down, chest lifts, inhale, half split, bring it back. Back to front, standing forward fold, halfway lift, lengthen. Exhale, release. One more right there, halfway lift. Plant your hands, Bakasana, close. I'm gonna watch you and drink my coffee while you do that. Nice. Step or float. Inhale up, exhale down. Downward facing dog, find your breath. Notice where you are. Take an inhale here. Open mouth, release. Another breath, open mouth, let it go. Right leg lift, up and back, long knee to nose, bring it in. Stay here, maybe shift a little further forward, chaturanga your arms. What does that look like? What does that feel like? Three-legged dog, length. Step your right foot all the way in, left knee goes down, fingertips stay down, chest lift, inhale. Half splits, bring it back. Into standing splits, please, left leg lift, inhale here. And toes on the mat. Utkatasana, chair pose. Bring your hands to heart center. Your left knee lifts, come all the way up to standing. Extend your left heel back, warrior three. Here you go, Zach, right here for you. Inhale here. Left knee comes back into the chest, come all the way up to standing again. Left ankle, top of your right knee, sit into a figure four. Scoot your seat way back and extend your arms forward. Pull through the back hip, left hip. Nice. Bring your hands back to heart center. Come all the way to standing again. Put your left foot down onto the mat. Inhale, arms reach up over your head. Hinge at the waist, forward fold. Halfway lift, flat back. Plant your hands, step or float through your vinyasa. Up, exhale down. Find your breath, inhale here. Open mouth, let it go. One more breath, release. Left leg lift, up and back, long knee to nose, bring it in, stay, or chaturanga your arms. Again, give it a feel, elbows stay over the wrist, three like a dog, lengthen. Step your left foot all the way in, right knee finds the mat, fingertips stay, chest lifts. Half splits, bring it back. Into standing splits, please, right leg lift, inhale. 10 toes on the mat, exhale, Utkatasana, chair pose, rise. Bring your hands to heart center, come all the way to standing. Bring your right knee into the chest, plug the femur into the hip socket, warrior three. Extend your right heel back. Find some stability. Center of the storm. Right knee comes back in. You come all the way to standing again. Plug it in. Right ankle, top of your left knee. Sit into your figure four. Scoot your seat way back. Extend your arms forward. Lean in, lengthen. Feel the shoulder blades plugging in behind you. Back into hands come to heart center. You come all the way to standing again. 10 toes on the mat, release. Arms reach up, inhale. Forward fold is your release. Halfway lift, fly back, plant your hands, crow pose. Step or float whenever you're ready. Inhale up. Exhale down. Beautiful. Inhale here, open mouth, release. Just like that. Ideally with sound effects, please. Inhale. And release. Right leg lifts, up and back. Long knee to nose, bring it in. Again, play with the chaturanga, your arms. Slower down. All the way back, three-legged dog. Right leg steps in, warrior two this time. Hug the right hip under as you come up. Up and over, reverse lift. Into extended side angle, please. Right arm reaches over underneath you towards the right, unsupported. Thank you. Back up and over. Arms go down, frame the foot, plant your hands. A right leg extends back to three-legged plank. Hold it right there. Push back through your right heel. Bend your right knee, create a little kickstand. Stay there, hips are low. Swing your right leg behind, side plank open. Breath. Beautiful. Right arm finds the mat. Right to right. Tap again. Three-legged dog lengthen. Right knee crosses under to the left tricep. Shoot your right leg up. Left arm rises. Nice. Left arm finds the mat. Knee to nose. Bring it in. Three-legged dog lengthen. Right leg steps in. Low lunge. Stay here. High on the back knee. Straighten your right leg. Dig your right heel into the mat. Chest lift. Back to front again, bend into that knee one more time, dig your heel into the mat, straighten. Back into the front knee, standing split, figure out the way to lift your back leg up. That could be a handstand next time, 10 toes on the mat, Utkatasana, chair pose, rise. Forward fold is your release, plant your hands, Bakasana, crow pose, step or float. I am really on that Utkatasana, Bakasana. Enjoy two more weeks of it. Up dog, down dog.
Nice, Shelly. Look at that.
I want to do the minute.
You're going to do the minute. Okay, well, you can do the minute when we're taking a break. Lift, lift, lift. Knee to nose, bring it in. Chaturanga your arms, maybe. Play with that. Three-legged dog, lengthen. Step your left foot all the way in. Left hip hugs under warrior two. Up and over, stay deep, strong, relax, extended side angle. The left arm reaches ahead of you in your gaze. Nice, back to reverse again, reach. Arms go down, frame the foot, plant your hands, three-legged plank. Left heel extends back, hold it there. Bend your left knee, flex the foot, hold it there. Notice the belly, the back, the collarbones. Swing your left leg behind you, side plank, off to your left. Left arm finds the mat, left to left, tap, three-legged dog, lengthen. Cross it under, left to right, hold, extend your left leg up, right arm comes up, hopefully you're hovering the whole time. Come on, Robbie, happy birthday. Right arm finds the mat, knee to nose, three-legged dog, lengthen. Left leg steps in, low lunge, stay here, high on the back knee. Straighten your left leg, dig it in, keep your hips in place. Back to front, bend. One more time, dig it in. Back to front, bend, prepare, weight shift, standing splits, right leg lift. What does that look like? 10 toes on the mat, Utkatasana, chair pose. Forward fold is your release, plant your hands. Bakasana, crow pose. It's step or float whenever you're ready. It's shuffling.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it's alright.
like the second last one.
If you pick it here.
But it doesn't matter. Make your way through your vinyasa, step or float. Inhale, up dog. Roll over your feet, downward facing. Left leg lifts, up and back, long. Knee to nose, bring it in around. Chaturanga your arms. Press back up, three-legged dog, lengthen. Step your left foot all the way in, right knee finds the mat. Chest lifts, fingertips stay, half splits, bring it back. Into standing split or into a hub. One breath, one movement. Left leg lands back into half split. Bring it back. All the way into a standing split. Again. 10 toes on the mat. Utkatasana, chair pose. Don't worry, we'll do it again. Forward fold is your release. Bakhasana is your inhale. Exhale, back onto your heels. Inhale, chair pose. Bring your hands to heart center, come all the way to standing. Right knee comes up and into your chest with you. Extend your right heel back, warrior three, find a breath, stay. Pull the thumbs through your sternum to pull the skin a little bit, elbows in. Back into standing, right knee comes in. Right ankle, top of your left knee, sit your butt way back, scoot it back. Arms reach over your head, flatten your back parallel to the ground. Breath. Arms go down. Maybe you play with the Padangalavasana or whatever you want to do here. You can also substitute for a one-legged crow or just play crow. Right? Totally up to you. Plenty of options. One side is always harder than the other. Correct. Step or float whenever you're ready. Nice. Inhale, up dog, roll over your feet, downward facing dog. Right leg lifts, up and back, long knee to nose, bring it in, chaturanga your arms. Again, notice elbows over the wrist, three-legged dog, lengthen. Right leg steps all the way in, warrior two, coming up. Hug the right hip under, up and over, reach. To extend inside angle, left arm reaches, right arm reaches, yes. Back to reverse again. Arms go down, frame the foot, plant your hands, three-legged plank, right heel on fire. Push back through that heel. Bend your knee, flex your foot, stay here. Take a breath, swing your right leg behind,
Right arm rises, maybe more of a flip dog, up to you. Right arm finds the mat, right to right, tap, make a connection, plug the heel in nice and tight to your side, three-legged dog. Cross it under, right to left, extend your right leg, right arm, left arm comes up. Left arm finds the mat, knee to nose, again, three-legged dog, lengthen. Right leg steps in, high on the back knee, straighten your right leg, take it in, back into front again. One more time, straighten, lift the hips, bend into forward, into standing split or into a hop. That one is tougher because your stands are a lot wider, right? Nice, 10 toes on the mat. Utkatasana, chair pose, rocks. Forward fold is your release. Plant your hands, bakasana, crow pose. Take a couple breath. And then through your vinyasa. Up, down. Beautiful. Left leg lifts, up and back, long. Knee to nose, bring it in. Chaturanga your arms. Three-legged dog, scoot it back. Step your left foot all the way in, warrior two, nice and steady foundation, up and over, lift. Extended side angle, left arm reaches ahead of you. Back to reverse again. Arms go down, frame the foot, plant your hands, left heel extends back, you hold. Find the fire. Left knee bends, flex your foot. Swing it behind you, side plank, more of a flip dog. Your shoulders are staying over the wrist, back to the mat. Left to left, tap again. Three-legged dog, lengthen. Cross it under, left to right, shoot your left leg out. Right arm comes up. Find your mat, knee to nose. Three-legged dog, lengthen. Left leg steps in. Stay here, straighten your left leg, dig it in. Lift the chest in towards the toes, bend into the front knee. One more time, a little hamstring stretch. Bend into the front knee, project your arms, find your way. Maybe you hop, maybe you don't. Toes on the mat. Utkatasana, chair pose. Forward fold is your release. Plant your hands, bakasana, crow pose. Step or float. Simplicity of the flow. out around by your arms, right? So you're here. So that's a really, really hard move. So knee to nose, chaturanga your arms. You are really working on the back foot as well, right? So notice if you are actually deep in your heel or if you are higher than tippy toe. Because when you are forward, like, you know, ready to kind of explode, you get an extra, I don't know, 2 inches of space, then you chaturanga, right? And then you go back. Feel free to skip that if that doesn't work. Obviously, a lot of fun legged standing movements per Zach's request. We're in standing, then we go to warrior three, and we go back into standing, right ankle on top, sit back, reach back, right? And then all the way down. So a lot of this happening, that's always fun. Square hips. It's a great move if you're thinking, if you're still playing with the idea that you are in the middle of a storm and then you have to negotiate a certain level of space, right? It's a one plane movement, which is nice. You're not doing any rotations or anything like that. So that keeps it nice and simple. All right, let's do it again.
Up and
down. Find your breath. Inhale. Open mouth. Let it go. One more breath. Open mouth. Release. Left leg lifts. Up and back. Long knee to nose. Bring it in. Maybe chaturanga. Push it all the way back. Three-legged. Left leg steps in. Right knee finds the mat. Fingers stay. Chest lift. Half splits. Prepare your arms. Coming forward into a hop or standing splits. Back into hop splits. With your breath, back into a hop or standing splits. 10 toes on the mat. Utkatasana. Chair pose. Forward fold is your release. Plant your hands. One breath into a crow. Back onto your heels. Chair pose. Rise. Hands come to heart center. Straighten your legs. Come to standing. Right knee comes in with you. Right heel extends back. Warrior three. Breath in here. Right knee comes back in. You come all the way up to standing. Watch your standing leg. Right ankle crosses. Sit your booty back. Arms extend forward over your head. Take a breath here. Arms go down. Plant your hands. Your option of, your choice rather, of a arm balance. Step or float. Nice, you guys. Downward facing dog. Left leg lifts, up and back, knee to nose, bring it in, maybe chaturanga. Three-legged dog, reach your foot back, step it in, tight foundation, warrior two. Up and over, reach. Extended side angle with your left arm out. Back to reverse. Arms go down, frame the foot, plant your hands. Left heel goes back, three-legged plank, hold. Find your foundation, bend your knee, flex your foot, stay. Now open. Left arm finds the mat again, left to left, tap again. Three-legged dog, cross it under, left to right, extend your left leg out, find some control. Right arm finds the mat, knee to nose, three-legged dog. Left leg steps in, low lunge, straighten your left leg, dig your left heel, the back heel is high. Back into front. One more time, bring it back. Back to front, into a hop or standing splits. Again, maybe take up the hops. The first one didn't work. And toes on the mat. Utkatasana, chair pose. Whew. Forward fold, into your release. Halfway lift, flat back, plant your hands, bakasana. Oh, well, that made me sweat just a little bit. But the breeze, the weather is just so good today. Up and down. Nice. Step it back. Shelly, I do think your hands need to go a little further apart. Just a tad. Okay. Yeah. I think that will help. Alright, drop down to your knees, you guys. And I'm going to show you something. And while, actually sit on your legs. And then I want you to put your right, bend your right knee and put your ankle underneath your left leg, yeah. And then just kind of notice. Loose. Right, just kind of notice where you are. A little bit of a lift through the chest, a little bit of a tilt of the pelvis forward, right? And then just kind of maybe kind of roll yourself forward with the lift. And then you scoot your butt back, right? So most often than not, this happens. You guys see how my right hip is way down and my left hip is way up, right? So what are you specifically focusing is on not doing that, right? So you gotta lift that right hip up into a line, right, with your left hip, and that's where the stretch on the outer left hip flexor comes in, right? So the moment you're here, you may not actually feel anything. I don't, right? The moment I pull the hips in place, I feel all of this, it like kind of getting. And same thing is happening when you're sitting, right? So if you are sitting like that and you don't feel absolutely nothing, then take your foot and put it on top, right? Because that will create more. Not, this is not available for everyone, right? Which is why the underneath a knee is a really good option for a lot of people. So you just kind of have to assess where your hips are. Now, another part of that standing fold, so just stay in there and then kind of fold and just keep listening, right? So as I shift the hips back and pull the right hip back in place, the other part that I also do, at least in the beginning, is I really lift through the heart, right? And then I reach my head forward, which is why I like the part of taking your arms with you. Gosh, if I could only find a balance there. Because that kind of pulls the shoulder blade in and it really makes me reach forward, hollowing out the belly. And now I can feel that my upper body is flat. So the moment you round, it's fine, nothing's happening. Same is happening in the hip, but there's just a different situation happening in the spine, right? So this is a spine flexion and this is a spine extension, or the other way around actually, right? So it's just something to pay attention. Can you, and also more often than not, we're just here, we're on our computers, or we're like whatever, on our phones, or we're in our chairs, watching TV like this, right? You really need to find this place, right? Anyway, that was my spiel. All right, so now when you were holding, now you can just fold. So now just bring your weight into it, round. And the rounding sensation is generally more comfortable than the lengthening for the spine because of all the stuff that we need to undo. So just again, kind of paying attention. Where your body lands. Now the other part of the process is I don't want you to get to 100% in the first 3 seconds, right? I want you to slowly get into a place of that feels good, and then perhaps once you're there, you take a couple breaths and then maybe you lean even a little further in. Alright, slowly coming back up, breath in, uncross your legs, extend the right leg back forward. And again, just take a notice where you are, whether you can actually find your butt bones, whether you can sit off them. A lot of people are sitting back here on their sacrum, right? So just kind of notice if the knees need to bend in order for you to really sit on your bones, then that's fine, then you do that. Left knee comes in, crosses either under your foot or on top of your leg, under your leg or on top of your leg. Lift up through the chest, coming forward. Maybe you just put your hands down. But again, keep lifting through the heart. So the heart is lifting to the high corner of the room. You are stretching the right hamstring here as well. Again, if you don't feel anything in an inappropriate place for you to feel this, would be a pinching or tearing sensation at the knee. You want or need to change the position of your legs. the breath in, lift up a little more, exhale, chin into the chest, round. And then kind of tune in, and then always notice, where do you feel it? Where do you feel this? So I feel it in the right glute as well as in the right hamstring. I feel it in the left outer hip flexor, but my right leg is actually in this position getting a little more work than my left. So I am gonna adjust because I want to get into the left hip flexor. So you always kind of gotta work with what you have. Each of our bodies are very different. Notice the back, what's happening across the back. Your full backside is getting a stretch if you're leaning. Notice if you're holding onto something, you're always trying to be held instead of holding. Once you get on the ground like this, slowly chin comes into the chest. Maybe you use your arms to push yourself up. Again, extending your leg, pausing there. And noticing if you have the butt bones connected, maybe the knees need to bend, maybe the chest can lift. Check in with the curve in your lumbar. And then bending the knees, soles of the feet onto the mat, grab underneath the kneecaps, lift. Lower all the way down, one vertebra at a time. Bridge or wheel in your future. That's where you'd like to go. So I don't know if we're quite born for wheel, but maybe we are. I don't know. Again, kind of tuning in with your body and check in with where you are. So bridge, Marlene, feet a little bit further apart, just a bit. There you go. Is that, does that feel better? Nikki, to take your feet a tiny bit apart, yeah? And then really push into your heels. Yeah, there you go. Does that feel better? And then upper back down first, mid back, low back, knock the knees together. And chill, wipe your legs, left to right. If there's anything else that you'd like to do before we settle in for our final rest, you have about a minute-ish or so. Time whenever you're ready. If you would bring your knees back into the chest, hug them in nice and tight, forehead to knees, wrap it all in, feel it all in. Again, find, come to that center space in the middle. Give yourself deep, kind of collect your particles, if you will. Lay the head and neck down first and slowly extend the feet into the corners of your mat. Soften the hips, connect the shoulder blades underneath you, wiggle out the jaw, soften the face. And then again, imagine that you're either standing or floating or laying in the center of your personal hurricane, that is your life. Take a big inhale in through your nose, slow open mouth nose. Again, breath in, inhale, open mouth, release, let it go.
breeze on your face. It's completely unaffected. It feels good. You have the ability to just watch out of that center, out of that calmness, noticing what is happening outside of the perimeter of your immediate space. If you can imprint that feeling of what it is to stand calmly in the center of your storm into your mind. Notice what your breath feels like. Notice how your body responds to it. And just know that you always have that available to you. Sometimes it may be a little harder to connect with that space than other times. But it's always there. Bring the awareness back into the breath. From an active inhale, active exhale. Need some movement to the fingers, to the toes. Stretch the fingers apart, stretch the toes apart. Arms reach up over your head, lengthen, reach, just like you're waking up in the morning. Maybe one leg, one arm longer than the other, other leg, other arm longer than the first. Knees come back into the chest.